Hey there, my name's Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to show you how to use the TinySA with SoundBase to get a better RF coordination in your church or venue. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear, no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, in a previous video, I demonstrated using SoundBase to get an RF coordination for your church or venue using the free account. But if you want to, you can do a pro account through SoundBase, and then you can do a scan with a spectrum analyzer directly within the program, and you don't have to do a scan outside to import. You can just do it all within SoundBase, which is super helpful. The other benefit of having a pro account is that you then have a piece of software that is on your computer that you can do all of your RF coordination with. So no longer do you have to have an internet connection to do your RF coordination. You can do it within your computer and then sync it to the cloud, of course, if you do have an internet connection. But in this video, I want to talk about this TinySA spectrum analyzer and how to use it within SoundBase. Now, the TinySA is about $70, and it is a spectrum analyzer that goes through and scans the frequencies in radio spectrum and will plot it out on a graph. And you can definitely use this by itself. Just turn it on and have your antenna, and it does the scan. Now, your spectrum scans are only as good as your antenna is. So the little antenna that's here is not the best antenna in the world. So if you do happen to have a wireless distribution system, I would do a scan with the omnidirectional antenna that's here. And then I would also connect this in with your wireless distribution for your RF and do a scan within that, which will then give you a very good define of what your spectrum looks like within your wireless equipment. But in this case, we want to make this size of this antenna to size with our normal frequencies that we're using. And so there are some calculators online for quarter wave vertical sizing, and then you can enter in your frequencies that you're going to be using, and then you can size this accordingly, because this is too long and this is too short. But a good example of a size would be about here. So I'm going to leave this about here to do my scan with. Now, the next thing that we want to do is we want to connect our little device into our computer. And so this TinySA has a USB-C. And so I have a USB-C cable here, and I am just going to connect this into our port here and connect this into our computer here. And so at this point, then we can open up SoundBase and we can do some configuration in here. So if we open up SoundBase and go to our default screen here, we can hit this gear icon down here, and then we can go over to Device Manager and we can add in our device. And so if I click in here and I delete this, I can go add, and we can select our device, and I have a TinySA, and we can enter in a name if we want to. And so I'm just going to type this in as TinySA. And if we want to add in our serial number, we can definitely do that. Once you've done that, you can go ahead and press save, and then you can go over to connection and we can select our TinySA and press apply. Now at this point, this has pulled up my TinySA and it is now connected into my computer. So now that we've connected to our TinySA, we can actually go and define our measurements. So I have one old device that is in the 600 megahertz band that I used before the band repack. And so I need to scan a very specific frequency pretty high up in the band to be able to get this a frequency. So I'm going to go all the way up to 670 megahertz. So I'm going to do a scan between 470 and 670. And if we want to have the best resolution, I would choose one of these higher options. But in this case, because I'm doing a video, I'm wanting this to be pretty quick for you guys so you don't have to sit here while this scans. So I'm going to go ahead and select 30 kilohertz. And once we've done that, we can press apply. So as we can see, we have our frequencies plotted here. So I can see that there is definitely a TV station right here, and we can see the pilot tone of this TV channel right here. We can also see that. And then if we go and look up higher in this, we can see that there is some wireless happening all the way up here. And so what my plan is here is to now scan for my frequencies that will work in this space. So I can go and now press incompatible, and we can recalculate all incompatible, and these are good, and I can press recalculate. And at this point, this is going to give me new frequencies that I can utilize for these wireless devices that will work with each other and the current scan that I have with my device. Now, once we've done our scan, if we want to, we can actually save this in the cloud and share it with other people that are also using SoundBase. So if you are in a pretty popular venue that a lot of people rotate through, then what will be beneficial is that you can then save this scan that you just did to the cloud, and then the next engineer that's going to be doing a show in that same venue or location will be able to pull up that scan via SoundBase and then be able to do an RF coordination before they even arrive at the venue, which is very kind. So to do this, all we have to do is press this little save icon, and you can actually go in and save this scan, mark if there are transmitters turned on or if there's not any transmitters turned on. In my case, I have two wireless transmitters turned on. I have my in-ear pack and my wireless for my head mic. And so we can save this and share it with the community if we want to. The benefit of doing a scan rather than just using the TV channels that pop up is we can see that there are some peaks here from any of our wireless that's happening in this room. So we can see that there is a little peak that's happening right here that wouldn't have shown up in the scan unless we actually had a wireless spectrum analyzer. So it's always a good idea to spend the money to get a little unit and do a scan to see where there are peaks. So for instance, if I had another wireless microphone and I didn't know about this transmitter that's right here, and I happen to place this microphone at 606 megahertz, then I would have some issues because there's already RF happening in this one spot. The other thing that I suggest is if you are doing a scan with a spectrum analyzer, turn off all of your wireless in the room or venue, and then you are getting a good picture of what the RF environment looks like without any gear turned on. That way you're getting a very clean scan. Now, if you're in, say, a hotel or a venue that has other things happening, it's always a good idea to reach out to the lead in that hotel or another audio engineer that's maybe at that same venue to see what wireless frequencies they are using. And if they're like, I just press scan, what you can do is you can ask them, hey, would it be cool if I give you some wireless frequencies? And then you can go ahead and add in a zone and give them their frequencies specifically for their spot, which is a very cool idea. Now, I am a huge fan of SoundBase and the SoundBase Pro because I'm able to use this software without a wireless internet connection, and I can scan within the app, which is fantastic. Now, if you want to learn more about SoundBase, you can go over to soundbase.app, sign up for a free account, and do a coordination for free for your venue or your shows. Now, if you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on SoundBase or RF coordination or really anything in production, please post that comment in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.